We're in southern Nineveh place, in Sheikh Mate, and four different villages are here as well, of Maghara, Al-Faf, and the other two. And right here, we're in a place where it was built, I guess, for a soccer field, but obviously it was never completed. The floor is just dirt, and it's pretty much just open space. It's owned by the monastery, and the people at the monastery said, you know, if you are willing to do anything with this, you're more than welcome to. Something that maybe could give the kids something to do. The villages here, they have lots of families, surprisingly, even though we're 5 minutes away. But people live here, and maybe we can try to give them something that they could be happy about here. And what we're doing is trying to renovate this building right here. The monastery built this building hoping that they could make a small clinic out of it with the support from the government. But of course, there is no Nineveh Iraqi government here. So this building has been left alone. It's just an empty space. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to renovate this building, fixing all of his windows first, his doors, and then try to turn it into like a community center for the kids, a place that they can have fun, they can play, and just have a good time. This was the idea of the Abuna, who's in charge here. Now, this building is owned by the monastery, but again, they were just waiting for someone here to do something with it, and that's what we're gonna try to do right here. We've already got someone to take the sizes of the different windows that needs to be fixed first. As you see, all the windows are broken. It's got a lot of different rooms. There's a lot of potential in here where we can make something really special here for the kids that are living in this area. Remember, this place is only 5 minutes away from ISIS. 5-10 minutes. You can see them right after that mountain right there. But we still have lots of families here living. And actually, a few have started to come back here. So we got the windows that we're going to be using to fix all the broken ones right here. About $400 worth of windows you see right here. We're going to be taking it tomorrow to the village. And you know, one of the things that we really like about this when we do things like this is that we're putting money back in the economy. So we're getting people like this young man right here to work and you know, to have a project. So anything that we do right here, we like to use local factories, local companies, so that we can support the economy of our people right here. And we got all the sizes right here. And the qiyasat, you know? Yes. How much are you show us?
It's good. I'm 28.
And so we just paid for it right here. And then we're going to drive early tomorrow to the villages. This man right here, he's actually displaced himself. He's from southern Nineveh Plains as well. He's from Baghdede. That village is still occupied by ISIS. But look at him right now, getting to work and, you know, for the other villages that we're going to be taking care of. We cannot emphasize how important it is putting money in the economy here. Our biggest project to date is going to require a lot of pipes because we're going to be connecting the building to the watering system. We're getting paint right now. We're getting the different colors. So the way it works is you actually have to mix it yourself. You get the color and you get the white and you put it together. We were trying to get actually some workers to do it for us, but they canceled out on the last day. So we're gonna be doing it by wearing dirty clothes. So we got everything that we need to do the painting. These are 6 buckets of white paint and we got the coloring tubes that we'll mix them and all the other materials that we're gonna go. And now we're ready to hit the road.
Yes.
We've started our biggest project to date thanks to the $2,500 donated by Joe. We have people already working with the paint and the doors and the windows. It's going to be converted into a community center for the kids here. It's going to encourage families who are living in the outskirts in the villages to come back and you know, be something special. To give you an idea of what we're trying to do here, we've labeled each room already. This is going to be the cafeteria room. This is going to be like the PlayStation room, the video games, as you see here. Hi, Mark.
Hi.
He's already working with the painting. This is going to be the gym. That's the management room right there. And then over here, we have the classroom over here. We have the game room here for the kids. Have the library. It's gonna be the first library this place is ever going to have. The kids' room right here. Has some. Hi. And then the women's gym. So this room is gonna be for these kids right here. The kids of the village. They were so interested in what we're doing, they're starting to help on this right now. Nice to hear.
Everyone here is working, taking off the baths. The kids are working on us, but this is going to be the place after all.
Okay, now we came to buy the pipes and the pump for the place because they don't have any water connection there. Here we are at the electric shop and we're gonna see what we're gonna take, the lights, the brackets, everything that we need. And we're finally here to get the kids' stuff, the chairs, and all the toys for them. Yeah, it looks like they have good stuff here, some cars. They have all the Superman and all the heroes.
هذا واحدة بألفين ثلاثة بخمسة سنة.
So we decided to take only one for the video games room. It's enough for four people to sit on, and it's black and it's cool. So the two library shelves are done, and he's working on the third one, and we're gonna take the receipt now. And the guy's working on the third one, and it's easy. We're gonna be finished by this afternoon, probably. Okay. For the library, the three shelves, 150 by 220, three of them, and it costs $1,000. First of all, thanks to John, Trevor, Shawn, Nobopaul, and Safeway Food Center for giving us the money, $6,000, to start the project in Southern Nineveh plant next to our metal. Now we're gonna take two Dorsonic TVs with 42 inches each. Here we go. We're gonna take two PS4 and two extra controls for it because it has only one in each. Hey guys, we're back today to buy the carpets. We're gonna take three. And one for the
city. We've arrived in another place and we got our truck right there full of things. We're gonna start working and turning this building right here into a new center.
Finally, the shelves are here and we're gonna be installing them today. But they're not responsible for the pipes and installing them. And we're talking to him to see if he can do it today. As you can see, the old pipeline system was all broken, and there is no use of using it. So plastic was not good. These are all the valves and all the bendings and all the connections that we need to arrange the pipe.
We arrived with all the stuff right here. We're gonna start working on the three rooms today.
نزل يا ماي بارك من الحاج
Our library is being tested by the young kids, making sure they're strong enough.
Okay. تريد ترجع لأربيليا؟ تريد تبقى هنا؟
لا، نبقى هنا.
تبقى هنا؟
ليش أنت تبقى قارة هوني؟
إن أنت تقبل، تقبل إحنا تبقى
أنا
هنا؟
أنا بغير.
إيه؟ أوكي، راح نروح لأربيليا نرجع بعد لعباد، أوكي؟
إيه. إيه. بس أنا أقول خليني قلبها مفتوح.
Now for this youth community center, we're gonna finish phase one today. There was a few small things that we needed to purchase, heaters and some other things that required for the piping and electricity. And also, we're getting all the books that we need for the library to go to.
Busy collecting books from many different places, different organizations. They help us out. We purchased some books as well. We spent about $200 for new books, and everything else that you see are books from other organizations and local clubs that they donated. So we're gonna take them off and go to Sheikh Mati.
هذا البوري لازم أما كسره أسوي قطع.
You see, this was the old system right here. It was done with plastic. We're not going to use this anymore. And you see over there, that's the iron one that we purchased. 17 long pipes that's going to go from the building. It's going to go down eventually. And then here. They already put most of it. It just needs to reach here.
Ustad Wa'ad, bas iftaha.
And so we got water. That means it's good to go now to the building.
This is the PlayStation room right here. It's gonna be a place for the people to, of course, play games. We got the big couch, we're about to move that in too as soon as you get this thing installed.
Yes!
Great, it's working! So the PlayStation room is set up, now we're testing it. We got a few boys right here checking it out, making sure it's working. Hi, can you stop it?
Good morning, my friend in America. I'm Father Joseph from St. Matthew Monastery. Here I want to thank everyone who gave donation to complete the first phase on this project, youth community project in St. Matthew land. And we want to thank Joe, Trevor, Shawn, Nobopaul, Salt Food Center for them donation and to make this the library, the child room and the PlayStation room, and for the piping and the electricity here in the center. We ask the God to bless them and to keep them doing to help these communities on these works. God bless you and thanks from St. Matthew Monastery and from all the managers in the monastery. Thank you very much, my dear.
Let's recap what we've done so far. We're done with phase one. We did the PlayStation room, so it looks all ready, it looks really good. We test everything, it works here. We painted all of the rooms, almost. We painted this room. We're still not sure what we're gonna use it for, but we're done with all the painting. That's the most important thing, it was one of the most difficult things. Of course,
course, we did all the lights for every single one of the rooms as well. You see right here. It didn't have sufficient lighting in each of the rooms, so we did that. With phase one. Again, the storage room we painted it, and the remaining rooms as well. This is going to be like a course, right? A class for courses, like English language courses or Syrian language courses. Again, all painted, all the lights done, so it's ready to use. All we need now is things for it in phase two. Also, the other room here, another activity room. Noor did a great job with painting. It looks wonderful. And of course, the two rooms that we finished, the library, we put all the books too, that all the different organizations gave us. Actually, one of the Abuna started was really excited. She was really happy. Even the principal saw some books she could start using just to make copies for the children for activities and stuff like that. So it's already going to be starting to be used. And of course, we have the children toy room right here, all painted as well. So we're done with that. And of course, the most important thing that we said, the water piping is done as well. We connected it. We're going to almost finish it. Hopefully, it will be done soon. We connected the piping all the way downstairs, and it will be all set for the building.